Hello everyone, welcome to Decode Your Skin. Today we will discuss about structure and microbiology of gonorrhea and pathogenesis of gonorrhea. This is the structure of the gonorrhea. The first picture showing that Neisseria gonorrhea. Neisseria gonorrhea is always arranged in a pairs, and this is in a kidney shaped and coffee bean shaped, and the outer membrane is called coating the cell wall of the bacteria, and this is the hair like structure called as pili. And the second picture that is showing, there are two surfaces that are covered by the gonorrhea bacteria. The one is outer cell membrane and the periplasmic membrane and inner cytoplasmic membrane. So the outer cell membrane, we have lipopolysaccharide, which is endotoxin, and peptidoglycan, and pore protein 1 and pilus, which is an hair like structure. And the inside we have IgA protease and cytoplasm and cytoplasmic membrane. Introduction. Gonorrhea is caused by an obligate human pathogen called as Neisseria gonorrhoeae or gonococcus. Second most prevalent bacterial sexually transmitted disease globally. Neisseria gonorrhoeae colonizes and infects primarily the mucosa of urogenital, anorectal, pharyngeal and ocular regions. So asymptomatic mucosal colonization to frank inflammatory mucosal disease, it causes urethritis, cervicitis, pharyngitis, proctitis and conjunctivitis. Gonorrhea does not affect the vagina as it is lined by the stratified squamous epithelium. It does not enter into the stratified squamous epithelium easily. And if untreated, inappropriately or treated, causes complications like pelvic inflammatory disease, disseminated gonorrheal infections and salpingitis, arthritis, dermatitis, endocarditis and meningitis. Gonorrhea significantly facilitates the HIV transmission through increased viral shedding from the inflamed mucosa. The history. During 460 and 370 BC, Hippocrates named it as stranguria, which means an acute gonorrhea. So in 130 and 200 AD, Galen coined the term gonorrhea. Gono means seed, oria means flow. So under the impression of that, the male discharge was an involuntary loss of semen, that is spermatoria. And 500 AD, Sushruta named it as disease of urinary passages. In 13th century AD, Gulliman D. Salcit described this as venereal nature by attributing the disease to impurities retained under the male prepuce after contact with an unclean female. In the 15th century, the sexual transmission of and contagious nature of the disease were established. In 1530, that gonorrhea was an early feature of syphilis. In 1767, John Hunter developed the syphilis after self-inoculation of the pus from the penile urethra of a patient who co-infected with syphilis and gonorrhea. And they thought that syphilis and gonorrhea is the same disease. But in 1792, Benzie and Bell conducted that both the diseases are separate entities. And in 1879, Albert Nizer named the micrococcus their gonorrhea in the stained smears of purulent urethral, vaginal and conjunctival exudates. In 1882, Litzkow and Loeffler grew the organism in vitro culture media of blood serum and gelatin. In 1884, Hans Gram demonstrated the bacteria as a gram-negative diplococci with gram staining. In 19th century, Thayer and Balmer documented the endocarditis and septicemia, and the selective medium for the gonorrhea is Thayer-Martin medium. And the last two decades, the nucleic acid hybridization test and nucleic acid amplification test, direct immunofluorescence and ELISA test were described for the diagnosis of gonorrhea. History of our therapy for gonorrhea was undergone several changes, replacing the old horrible therapies such as urethral astringents and urethral soundings, mechanical devices and chemical therapy with urethral irrigation with potassium permanganate and silver nitrate solution. In 1936, first antimicrobial agent used for the treatment of gonorrhea was sulfonamides. In 1943, the penicillin was introduced in the treatment of gonorrhea. Epidemiology of gonorrhea. It's second most prevalent bacterial and sexually transmitted disease globally and has remained a major public health concern worldwide. In 1999, 62 million new cases of gonorrhea were estimated among adults between the age group of 15 to 49 years. Cases mostly reported in the South and Southeast Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa, mostly in the developing and less resourced settings. In many developed and more industrialized countries such as Western European countries and USA. Biology of Neisseria gonorrhoeae. Neisseria gonorrhoeae belongs to the family Neisseriaceae that includes 5 genera like Neisseria, Kinginella, Inkinella and Simoncinella and Alaciella. The genus Neisseria contains 2 human pathogens, those are Neisseria gonorrhoeae and Neisseria meningitidis. 38 pathogenic commensals, mostly seen over mouth and upper respiratory tract and rarely on urogenital tract. Neisseria gonorrhoeae is a gram-negative, aerobic, diplococci, capnophilic, non-flagellated, non-sporulating, oxidase and catalase producing bacteria. So in the microscopy, the Neisseria gonorrhoeae is a size of 1.5 to 1.6 into 0.7 to 0.8 micrometer in size. Neisseria gonorrhoeae is a fastidious and requires complex nutritionally enriched culture medium for in vitro growth. So the bacterium can only utilize the glucose, lactose, glucose or pyruvate as carbon source for that is used in the species verifying carbon utilization test. So Neisseria gonorrhoeae only degrades glucose but not maltose, fructose, sucrose or lactose. Human is the only natural host for Neisseria gonorrhoeae. So in vitro growth is obtained at temperature of 35 to 37 degrees Celsius in 4 to 6% carbon dioxide atmosphere at a pH of 6.5 to 7.5. The high variability of Neisseria gonorrhoeae is valuable for evasion or adaptation to the immune response of the host and for the development and antibiotic resistant mechanism. These properties make the bacteria effective in persisting without severely damaging the host, producing mild and asymptomatic infections. So molecular structure of Neisseria gonorrhoeae, it's a chromosome. All the genomes had a size of 2.1 to 2.2 MB, 52 to 53% of genetic coding content and encoded with 2100 to 2300 genes. Plasmids, there are 3 types of plasmids that are required in the molecular structure of Neisseria gonorrhoeae, cryptic plasmid and beta-lactamase encoding plasmids. Beta-lactamase encoding plasmids, in 1976, beta-lactamase producing plasmids in Neisseria gonorrhoeae strains from Asia, Africa. The beta-lactamase was an M1 type, causes a high level of penicillin resistant by hydrolyzing the cyclic amide bond in beta-lactam ring. Now these plasmids are widespread globally. The conjugate plasmids, in 1985, TET-M carrying conjugative plasmid was American TET-M plasmid in Streptococcus and mediated and high level resistant to tetracycline. So nowadays, the tetracycline resistant Neisseria gonorrhoeae with TET-M carrying plasmids are widespread. The cell wall and the outer membrane. As we previously discussed, the cell wall consisting of gram-negative bilayered outer membrane, phospholipids and lipooligosaccharides and proteins. There is a thin peptidoglycan layer which contains N-acetyl glucosamine, N-acetyl muramic acid and N-acetyl glutamic acid and diaminopamilic acid and alanine. So bilayered inner cytoplasmic membrane envelops the colloidal system of the cytoplasm composed of organic, inorganic solutes in the viscous solution. So this is a picture showing the outer membrane and the peptidoglycan in the periplasmic space and inner cytoplasmic membrane. The structures that are seen in the outer membrane is an hair-like pillars and it's an lipooligosaccharide and there is a protein, spore B protein, and RMP protein and OPA protein, OMPA. In there is an peptidoglycan, we have N-acetyl glucosamine, N-acetyl muramic acid and glutamic acid and alanine. This is an PBP1, PBP1 and PBP2, where the penicillin comes and binds. This is present situated inside the inner cytoplasmic membrane. The outer membrane structures. The outer membrane structures includes lipooligosaccharide which consisting of lipid A moiety, confines to the endotoxic activity and elicitating an host immune response core oligosaccharide, that is ketodeoxyconic acid, and this is involved in the adhesion, invasination and the toxicity of the host epithelial cells. This is a target for bactericidal and chemotactic antibodies. Silylation of lipooligosaccharide increases the antigenic variation and affects the invasion of epithelial cells, which inhibits the bactericidal activities of antibodies against pore B and lipooligosaccharides and OPA A proteins and phagocytosis of neutrophils, and complement activation by factor H binding results in the serum resistance. So the pili is also an hair-like appendage. It is also an outer membrane structure. This is composed of thousands of pilin and the protein subunits in association with the pilus. So these are associated with initial adhesion to human epithelial cells. The bacteria attaches to the human epithelial cells with the help of pilus and promotes the virulence by preventing the neutrophilic phagocytosis. So the mature pili is major subunit of the pilus fiber. Pili E, pili C are essential for high-level transformation of exogenous DNA. Pili E is a functional encoding gene. Pili C is a protein involved in the biogenesis and adherence functions of pili. Pili S, interstring recombination, horizontal exchange between the different pili S genes. The porin proteins, pore B protein, present in outer membrane, physically proximate to lipooligosaccharide and RMP proteins as a pore-forming transmembrane protein, which allows an hydrophilic solutes anions to diffuse through the outer membrane. Pore B is the target for bactericidal opsonicin antibodies and which induces the apoptosis of target cells. The gonococcal strains expresses only one of two different of proteins, pore B1A and pore B1B. The opacity and the other proteins. OPA proteins facilitate the intimate attachment between the gonococci within the culture colonies. The attachment to invasion of epithelial cells and neutrophils to the host. So OPA mediated and OPA independent invasion of epithelial cells mediate the evasion of complement dependent bactericidal activities, degranulation and phagocytosis of neutrophils. OPA genes and high level antigenic variation and evasion of host immune system. So the IgA proteases, which are extracellularly secreted by the pathogenic Neisseria, it promotes the mucosal colonization due to their degradation of IgA1 antibodies. So IgA proteases are also an important for intracellular survival in the epithelial cells through alteration of lysosomes. This is the short table where there is an virulence factors of Neisseria gonorrhoeae is discussed. This is a capsule which prevents the phagocytosis and the pili which mediates the attachment of gonococci to the non-ciliated epithelial cells and prevent the ingestion and killing of gonococci by neutrophils. Pore proteins confer the resistance to serum killing of gonococci by preventing fusion of phagolysosome in neutrophils. OPA proteins mediate the bacterial adherence to each other and to eukaryotic cell. RMP proteins produce an antibodies that block the serum bactericidal activity against the gonococci. Lipooligosaccharide possesses the endotoxic activity to the bacteria. IgA protease destroys the IgA immunoglobulin. Beta-lactamases degrades the beta-lactam ring in the penicillin and the plasmids. Plasmids are bound for the virulence determinants associated with the antimicrobial resistance. Phenotypic characterization of gonorrhea. These are oxotyping. Oxotyping dividing the strains into oxotypes based on their nutritional requirements for amino acids, purines, pyrimidines and vitamins. These methods are helpful in assessing the potential virulence, invasiveness, antimicrobial susceptibility, genetic constitution of various gonococcal strains. Pore B based serological characterization. The serogroup W1 pore B1A protein or W2 and W3 or pore B1B protein. By using coagglutination technique with monoclonal antibodies and are based on antigenic diversities of the outer membrane protein pore B. So internationally more widely used is genetic method, genetic system panel and pharmacia panel of monoclonal antibodies has been used. Antimicrobial susceptibility testing, antibiograms of Neisseria gonorrhoeae strains were used to determine relationship between the bacterial isolates. The antibiograms generate the valuable clinical information and are essential for monitoring of changing pattern of antibiotic susceptibility, thereby contributing to early warnings of emergence of resistance to different antibiotics. agar dilution method is the gold standard method for susceptibility testing or determination of minimum inhibitory concentrations of different antimicrobials less suited for routine susceptibility testing. So beta-lactamase production is often analyzed by a chromogenic cephalosporin test using a nitrosiphon disc or solution. This is a picture showing E-test method is commonly used for routine susceptibility. Antimicrobial susceptibility testing of Neisseria gonorrhoeae by using E-test method. The phenotypic epidemiological characterization method suffers from several disadvantages. For example, suboptimal discriminatory ability and limited access to monoclonal antibodies of adequate quality. So, another genotypic characterization of Neisseria gonorrhoeae. It's basically two methods are used. The gel-based DNA-based typing method and DNA sequence based typing method. In a gel based method, which includes a plasmid content analysis or restriction fragment length polymorphism, which is known as RFLP, determination using the pulsed eyelid gel and electrophoresis or ribotyping and OPA typing. The DNA sequence based typing method, which includes full or extended length or pore B sequence analysis. Neisseria gonorrhoeae is a multi-antigen sequence typing and multi-locus sequence typing. In general, appropriate validated quality assured genotypic methods based on DNA sequencing has been internationally recommended for the use. If an available, affordable, and there is any selection of appropriate genotype method could be guided by its performance characteristics and whether there is any short-term epidemiology, then it is in a micro epidemiology, whether it's long-term or global, then it's in a macro epidemiology matters are being investigated. Currently, for microepidemiological questions, the best methods were Neisseria gonorrhoeae MAST examines the variable internal fragments of pore B and TPPB or full or extensile pore B gene sequencing. For macroepidemiological studies, we have phylogenetic studies, DNA sequencing of chromosomal housekeeping genes such as MLST. Disease transmission. Neisseria gonorrhoeae is an obligate pathogen. Infected humans is the only natural reservoir for the bacterium. Neisseria gonorrhoeae primary infects transmitted by the direct human-to-human contact between the mucosal membranes of urogenital tract, anal canal and oropharynx during the activities, vaginal sex, oral and anal. So the transmission efficiency of number of exposures and sites infected was infected woman to uninfected man in one exposure is 20%. Infected woman to uninfected man in four exposures is 60-80%. And the infected man to uninfected woman is 50-90% even in a single exposure. The transmission efficiency based on sites, if the disease is present in the urethra, then it is 72%. If disease is present in the pharynx, then it is 20%. Transmission of the disease from the pharynx to urethra can occur, and the neonates can be infected during the passage to the birth canal if the mother has urogenital gonorrhea. Non-sexual transmission mainly causes ocular infections in neonates, ophthalmia and uniterum. Transmission by fomites or through non-sexual routes is very rare, and the no evidence that is showing that transmission occurs by toilet seats or droplet infection. So urogenital gonorrhea is an asymptomatic in approximately 50-80% of the women and 2-10% of the men. Gonorrhea is an initiated as a pyogenic infection of the urethra in males and endocervix in females. Incubation period is mostly 14 days and average of 2-7 days. Risk factors are young age 15-49 years and early onset of sexual activity, being unmarried, being man and who have sex with man, previous gonorrhea and other STDs and concomitant STD and multiple partners, inconsistent condom use, poverty, unemployment and migration of populations. Pathogenesis of gonorrhea. Primary infection commonly occurs in the columnar epithelium of urethra, paraurethral ducts, glands, cervix and conjunctiva, Bartholin duct and rectum. Infection may also occur in stratified squamous epithelium of vagina and prepubertal girls, gonorrhea, vulva, vaginitis. The female urethra often escapes the infection owing to its lining with stratified squamous epithelium. So male urethra is lined by columnar epithelium and favors the penetration of gonococcus. There are main three steps for the pathogenesis of gonorrhea. First is adherence, invagination and tissue damage. First, the adherence. With the help of villi E and OPA proteins, the gonorrhea adhere to the host epithelial cells and helps in the escape of gonorrhea from the immune response. So, the invasion. In invasion, the pore proteins, endocytosis and pseudopod formation occur after invasion and then transported to the base of the cell called exocytosis, followed by the multiplication in the intracellularly. So, tissue damage. Lipoligosaccharide and peptidoglycan are tissue toxins which stimulate the production of TNF-alpha, TNF and neutrophils are attached to the site, and large number of polymorphonuclear neutrophils containing gonococci enter into the lumen of urethra. Serum and desquamation epithelium forms a profuse yellow discharge, together forms a serosanguineous discharge, which is a characteristic of disease. This is a picture and path showing the pathogenesis of Neisseria gonorrhoeae. First, the bacteria enters into the tract and it attaches to this columnar epithelium with the help of a pili, where there is an endocytosis happens, and it reaches to the base of the cell where exocytosis happens, and neutrophils and TNF factors are accumulated, and lipooligosaccharide, which is a lipopolysaccharide, which is a tissue toxin. The bacteria enters into the polymorphonuclear cells, where the intracellular multiplication of the bacteria takes place, along with the damaged epithelium and intracellular, and the discharge that comes enters into the tract, which is a serosanguineous discharge and which is a characteristic feature of the disease gonorrhea. This is a gonorrhea pathogenesis and overview. Neonatal transmission, direct to contact of a patient mucosa with the mother's infected mucosa while traveling down the birth canal. Sexual transmission, direct contact of patient mucosa with infected mucosa. Auto inoculation, immediate transfer of bacteria to the patient mucosa via indirect contact with infected mucosa. So the bacterial components, including pili and other proteins, also allow the adherence to host mucosal cells. Attachment of mucosal cell surface and the bacterial porins and proteins form in the host cell membrane, inducing the endocytosis by the host epithelial cells, and the bacteria invade and replicate with columnar epithelial cells and the host immune response. If there is any host immune response is good, then successful eradication of the bacteria and the pathogen is cleared from the host. If there is any host immune response is not that good, then the bacterial phagocytosis happens, and by circulating monocytes and the unsuccessful eradication of the pathogen, bacterial proteins block the phagolysosome fusion and polymorphonuclear neutrophils oxidative burst that causes the survival and replication within the leukocyte phagolysosome. Then there is a dissemination of the pathogen, and all these factors, multifactorial process, leads to the ability to avoid the host immunity. So the antigen variation of the proteins and lipopolysaccharide on the bacteria and the masking of gonococcal antigen by lipopolysaccharide prevents binding of bactericidal antibodies and causes incomplete activation of complement system and molecular mimicry, for example, terminal lipopolysaccharide sugars similar to that of host glycolipids, and secretion of IgA proteases, and the blocking the antigen by binding the host antibodies to bacterial reduction modifiable protein, that is RMP1, and the host immunity is avoided. Signs and symptoms of gonorrhea infection are seen. Thank you.